What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about Windows 11 branding, customizing it. So let's get right into it. All right, so within this video, I'm actually using this zip file, the Windows 11 branding.zip, which is found within this repository. It's legit, you know, it's well known. There's a couple of other things that I am going to touch base later on, but the first one is Windows 11 branding. So I downloaded the zip file, I extracted everything, and I dropped it into this UNC path, which is what we're going to copy and paste because we're going to head over to my SCCM server and create a package. Now, before you do all that stuff, within the 4K screen, user account pictures, the lock screen, there's going to be a lot of PNG, JPEGs, and I believe a bitmap image. You need to make modifications on that. I'm not going to show you how to do that. The way I did it behind the scenes was I opened all those files within Photoshop, and I just basically slapped the image that I want. All those images already have all the dimensions. All I had to do is just slap my image, resize them, save them down into this particular folder, and I was done. We're going to open up our Microsoft Configuration Manager console. Within here, we're going to go into software. Within software, we're going to double click on application management. And within here, we're going to click on packages. I'm going to right click on the packages node. I'm going to create a new package and we're going to get the wizard. I'm going to give it a name, a language, and a version. It's up to you if you want to give it a description. I'm going to give a check mark to this package contains source files. I'm going to click browse and I'm going to paste that UNC path of where the Windows 11 branding files are located. Click OK. Click next here. It is going to be a standard program, so click next. We're going to provide a name, a command line, and I'm going to change the program can run to the following. So this is the name. The command line is going to basically, you know, run that replacewallpaper.cmd file that's located within that folder, and program can run whether or not the user is logged in. So we're going to click next here. This program can run on any platform, so I left it as the default. Click next. Nice little summary, next, and you're done, and let's close it. Now, we're going to select and right-click our package, and we're going to click on Distribute Content. We're going to click Next here. We're going to click on Add. Click on Distribution Point. We're going to select our DP. Click OK. Click Next. Nice summary. Click Next, and we're done. And hit Close. Now, on the lower right-hand side where it says Content Status, it's going to say In Progress. I like to wait until it changes to green, success. That basically tells me to go. Now, we're going to go inside the operating systems folder. Let's go inside task sequences. I'm going to select the task sequence that I want to add this new package into. We're going to right-click on it. We're going to click on edit. And within here, we're going to click on add. We're going to add a new group. We're going to give our group the following. This is up to you. Within this group, I'm going to click Add again. We're going to go to General, and we're going to select Install Package. Now, the name for the package is the following. Again, this is really up to you. Once you give it a name, let's click on Browse. Select our new branding package that we just created together. Select it. Click OK. We're going to apply it. We're going to OK it. Stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. I'm going to show you like a fast video of how the deployment actually worked. It worked really well. Everything worked kind of seamless. I think the only mistake that I did was one of the images was a bitmap and I saved it the wrong way within Photoshop and it did not work within the deployment. So I had to go back in and redo that bitmap image. I think the bitmap is used for, I think, the user account icon. I'm not too sure. But that's it. Hopefully, you guys stay tuned for the rest of the video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.